I'm Chef Roman here, and today we'll be making some traditional Italian focaccias. And this will be a new menu item for the summer, so we wanted to give you a little preview of that and kind of get you excited for what's coming. So I wanted to give a quick little shout out before we get started to Chef Mari at Prime Alture in Casteggio, where I did a little summer internship. And he's the one that showed me this Italian focaccia recipe, so you know it's good if it's a real Italian chef. So here we have our dry ingredients. I pre-measured everything, so we have some bread yeast, some salt, some sugar, and then I have a mix of two flours here. So we have a bread flour, the same as I use in the baguettes. It's the Lonesome Stone Mill artisan bread flour, and then I just have some normal all-purpose flour. So to start, we will mix all of these together, just dry, in our big mixer. And then we will add an emulsion of water and olive oil. So our mixing is done here. So we have our dough. And what I was looking for in the mixing was just that the dough kind of cleaned the inside of the bowl and detached from the bowl and the hook. And so now we're just gonna knead this a little bit. So I'm kind of just gonna stretch it and pull. And just try to make this kind of a little bit nicer and kind of come together a little bit more. Alright, so now our dough is kneaded and we formed a nice ball here. So we're going to put it back into the bowl with some oil, just so it doesn't stick. So I'm going to get some oil in there. We're going to put the dough and kind of just move it around and then get some more oil on there. You got to be using some good extra virgin Italian olive oil, some high quality stuff, because kind of one of the main flavors in this focaccia is the oil. So we're gonna oil our ball up here, cover it, and it'll go in the proofer for about an hour. It should about triple in volume, and then once that's tripled, we will divide it, spread it out in pans, and get it proofing again, and then we'll be ready to bake. All right, so our focaccia has proofed for about an hour. It's tripled in volume, so I'll get it out of the proofer. We'll dump it on the table here, split it into four. So I got these kind of half pans here. It's 18 by 13. And then we'll spread it out in the pan and continue from there. So you can see this definitely grew. Now we got probably about three times as big as it was when we started. It's got nice and soft. So we'll just spread it and cut it in four here, as evenly as you can. Then we'll take a parchment lined tray. It just makes it a lot easier to get out. We're gonna oil it. And just kind of spread that around, because this will make a really nice crisp crust on the bottom. All right, and then we get our dough here, and I'm just gonna let gravity do some of the work right now. So we're just gonna let it kind of stretch And then we'll shape it a little bit nicer once we get into that pan. All right, and then we'll just kind of spread it out as good as we can. Might have to let it rest just a little bit so we can spread it easier. We'll try to get it into the four corners here. So we have the focaccia dough spread out as evenly as we can into the pans here. And the next step will be the fingers, kind of the finger dents or the finger holes. So what I'm gonna do here is you just kind of, what I found is you take your three fingers, three kind of middle fingers here, oops, and then just go down and basically press all the way to the bottom of the pan. And what this will do is the next step, we're gonna put some oil and water over it for moisture. And these little holes are gonna hold some of that oil and water in, and it'll make it nice and moist. Alright, so we got our fingers dents in there, so I'm gonna just mix this up here as good as we can. And then we're gonna pour it over the top. And then we'll kind of work it in a little bit more too with our fingers. And then these go into the proofer for about another hour. And what I'm looking for is it to basically puff up, you know, up to the edge of the pan. All right, so we got our oil and water poured over. So these will go into the proofer for about another hour. At home, you can just let it rest in a warm spot. And then we'll be ready to bake. So we'll bake the focaccias. And then if you want to do a flatbread pizza, then we can put toppings and we'll just bake it again just real quick to kind of melt things. So our focaccia has proofed for about another hour, and I'll take it out so you can see. Look at that beautiful baby. So we got the oil and the water on top. It's raised above the edges. So we're looking pretty good. And our last step, very important, before putting it in the oven, because we're gonna get a little bit of salt sprinkle on there. So I'm using some coarse salt, and you kind of have to go like this, I think. That's what I heard that makes it a lot better. So we'll go like that. All right, that should be pretty good. So I'm gonna put these into the oven at 400 degrees for 10 minutes. And then after that 10 minutes, we're gonna rotate and we'll turn it down to 350. We'll go another 10 minutes. So our focaccias spent 10 minutes at 400, another 10 minutes at 350, and it's looking beautiful, so I'll take it out. So there she is. And this is wonderful, just like this. Plain, warm, right out of the oven. Cut little pieces off, it's nice and crispy. But I wanted to show you what we'll be doing with the focaccia at the bistro for this summer, is we'll be putting some toppings on. So the one we'll do today is kind of a tomato-based one. We'll put some olives, some caramelized onions, some spicy Italian ham, and then some cheese. So we'll start first with the sauce here. Get it nice and saucy. And one thing I did want to mention too, if you don't want to put toppings, you can put some of these things directly into the dough, and it really flavors the bread. So I've seen, you know, traditional olive focaccia, rosemary focaccia, you know, it's really nice with herbs in there. You can put cheese and just bake it directly into the focaccia and just eat it like that. It's also real good. Got some Kalamata olives, we got some caramelized onions I did this morning. Get some ham on there. We have some Parmesan cheese. And I got a little goat cheese too. And one idea I had for another one will be a white sauce. So I'll do like a garlic cream sauce, kind of like Alfredo. I'll put some grilled chicken, some bacon. So you know, everyone loves bacon. So that'll be another. I'll do a pesto one for a vegetarian option. So we got tons of ideas. You'll just have to come check them out. And then just the last little finishing piece here. Got some fresh basil from the Bistro Herb Garden outside. So we'll just kind of plop those on. Then we'll throw this in the oven for just about, you know, 5 to 10 minutes at most, just to get the cheese melted and make everything look great. All right, so our focaccia with the toppings went in for about 5 minutes, so I'll get it out here. That's looking pretty tasty. And we'll attempt to cleanly get it out of the pan here. But what's nice about using the parchment paper is that it makes this job a lot easier. So if you wanted to serve this, I would suggest, you know, getting like a nice wood cutting board. And then what we can do here, listen to that. So at the bistro, I'll cut it in four like this, and that's your serving. So you might need to bring a friend. But then just to serve a single piece, I'd probably do something more like this, where I would cut it in like triangles or so. That just kind of makes a nice presentation. Or kind of strips like this. And it's hot. It smells great. So then you could arrange that on a plate and maybe have a salad with it. I hope you enjoyed watching the process of the focaccia flatbread here, and that you can come out and join us at the winery and sit on the patio with a glass of wine or a cocktail. like to also mention that I'll be offering the flatbreads like this as take and bake. So you get a full flatbread that you can take home and bake yourself. But I do all the work beforehand. So I guess the only thing we have left to do now is taste some of this lovely focaccia and drink some of this lovely wine. Mmm.